Hello everyone, my name is Tom Johnson from WPWithTom.com, and today I'm going to teach you how to install WordPress on Hostgator. So if you need help setting up WordPress within Hostgator, this is the tutorial for you. Hey everyone, so within this tutorial I'm going to go through the process of signing up for a hosting account and registering a domain name with Hostgator. If you already have an account and domain name with Hostgator, you can skip towards the middle of the video when I pick up on how to actually do the install of WordPress. But for now, we're just going to go to Hostgator. And if you want to, you can just type in Hostgator here. Go to Hostgator.com in my case. It may have a different country code, TLD here if you're in a different country. And now when you get to the home page of Hostgator, it may look a little bit different when you come there, depending on when you do come. I'll just click on where it says web hosting, or you can click on get started now, either one. And now you can click choose a plan. And here we have the three options that come standard with shared hosting plans within Hostgator. There's the hatchling plan, the baby plan, and the business plan. So there's different options in regard to these, but for this, you need to know with the hatchling plan, you have a single domain name. So I would only recommend this if you only have one domain name. Say you have a company or business and you know that it's the only domain name that you're going to need. If you are maybe an aspiring web developer or designer that wants to start designing websites in WordPress for clients, I would recommend that you go with this baby plan here, because you can host probably about 150 domain names before you start running out of the unmetered disk space that they offer you. And here you can go with a business plan, and this really is very similar to the baby plan, but one of the things they offer is a free toll-free number. I really don't think it's quite worth it, and I would recommend going with this baby plan. So if we sign up now, we are then prompted to this area where we can enter our domain name that we want to have. I highly recommend that for this TLD, which means top level domain extension here, that we choose .com if possible. If you have a charity or something like that, you may want .org, but I recommend that you go with a .com domain name if possible, at least if you're in the US. Maybe if you're in the UK, you do .co.uk or something like that, a country code if it's specific. I know Canada, some they have .ca, but in my case, I'm going to want to go .com because it is the most common. Here's where you're going to enter your domain name. So I'm just going to call this WPWithTom2.com. And I own WPWithTom.com, but for this tutorial, I'll just show you how to do this. And here it says $12.95 a year. Now, if we go down, it has a privacy protection added automatically. They check this box for you. I personally don't think it's worth having privacy protection on the domain name. It just will keep your information hidden from the public. And I will say, when you first sign up and register a domain name, some people try to contact you through this information and do web design services for you. But besides that initial sign up, I don't think you really get contacted much at all. And it's usually just a few emails, if that. So I would recommend that you do not take this $12.95 a year privacy protection. Here we have different plans. And within here, we have the baby plan that we're on, the hatching plan, or the business if you want to change. Again, I say you should stick with the baby. And here's the billing cycle. Now, I don't recommend that you do plans that are very long. I would say maybe a year or 1 month. And I actually have a coupon for 1 month, and it will give you the first month for free. And because there is a 45-day refund period, if you want to cancel the plan, if you find out that it's not for you, you don't have to spend anything except a cent to get started. And if you want to just stop using the plan and you decide not to make any more websites, you will just have that 1 cent expense, and I believe they cannot refund you for the domain name purchase of $12.95. So you would really initially be spending just $12.96 to get started, and you can stop the plan if you decide that it's not for you. So I recommend just going with the month rather than paying a whole year up front or 3 years up front or something like that, just to try it out. Now here's where you're going to enter your username information, and I'll just add that for now. And I'll put a random PIN number, add here, and now I'll scroll down, and this is where you would fill out your billing information. I'm not going to waste your time by filling out all this information right now for this tutorial, but after you fill out that information, you can go down to section 4 here where it says add additional services. I am going to uncheck the secure and accelerate your site, and you can add these services later. I want to be positive that you know this, and you can uncheck this one as well. I don't recommend getting any of these upsells that they have here because you can always add them later, and I frankly just don't think it's worth spending that much money right off the bat in case you don't really end up liking it to begin with. So I have a coupon code, as I said. My coupon code down here is WPWithTom1cent. And if we click validate, we'll see that now this amount went from $26.95 to $12.96, just as I said. So that's $12.95 for the domain name itself and 1 cent for the hosting plan for the first month. Now, if you continue to go with the hosting plan, it'll be about $10 a month after that. But you only have that $12.95 expense for the first year, and then you have to renew it the second year. That goes for any domain name, really, that you purchase. You're always going to have this reoccurring domain expense once a year. And to have hosting, you need to have hosting to really have your website live with like a professional-looking appearance. You don't want your website to say mywebsite.blogger.com or something like that. So if you want to, you can go and read these terms of service here, the cancellation policy, which I've described to you is the 45 days. It says right here, money back guarantee, 45 days. And there's terms of service, cancellation policy, and the privacy policy. After you've done that, you can just click, I have read and agreed to these terms of service. And then you click check out now. I wanted to point out to you that that code that I gave you is an affiliate code, and I wanted to be transparent about that. That allows me to make these videos for free and make the website tutorials that I continue to make for free. And I wanted to point that out to you, that that's an affiliate code. And it does really help me out, so I would really appreciate it if you find this tutorial beneficial if you do use that. And if you're having issues, definitely reach out to me and I'll be here to help. So after you do sign up for the account, you'll have an email sent to your account from Hostgator and it will say your account info on it. Now what you'll need to do is you can go to the control panel here and you click that link and it will open up in a new tab, but you'll need to copy in your username and your password information. I'm definitely going to have to change my password after this video, I just realized. So you'll have to change the password information here if you would like, and we're going to copy it in and we'll paste it in here and click login. It says login successful, redirecting. And now when we're in the back end here, it's going to say get started now, or you can click no, I'm fine, thanks. And you may have some other pop-ups that you can just click out of. What we're going to want to do to get started is, since you have just one domain on it, we do not have to click add on domains or subdomains. If you for some reason had a different registrar, if you registered for your domain with GoDaddy or something, you would want to go through the add on domains and add in that domain name. But for this tutorial, I'm just going to jump in how to install WordPress. So what we'll want to do is we'll go to quick install here. And after we click on quick install there, it takes us to this next page. And what we're going to need to do is just go to where it says WordPress here in the upper left area. This layout may change again, but just click where it says WordPress. And it says free option here. Install WordPress for free. And that's what we want. We want to click install WordPress. And now I actually added a subdomain name here, test.wpwithtom.com. And because I already have the root domain name, wpwithtom.com, I didn't want to have to purchase another one just for this tutorial. So we can add our information here. This information for the admin email we can change at a later point, but this admin username I do not believe we can change, or at least it isn't very easy to change like the admin email is. So what you can do here is you can put a good email that you're going to remember. So in my case, I'll just put wpwithtom.com. In this area, blog title, we can definitely change that at a later point. I'm just going to put just another WordPress site because that's a common thing you put. I'm going to put my first name and last name here. And for the admin username, I would not put admin. That is a big security no-no when it comes to WordPress. So I would put something, even if you just put your name, it would work great. Something that you're going to be able to remember. And now, if we go down, we just simply click Install WordPress. And now we can X out of this box, and it will say your install is running. And it says View Details. Once it goes all the way in about a minute here, it'll say View Credentials. And there it is. It says your install is complete. Click here to view your notifications. What you'll want to do is click on this View Credentials here, and you can use this link right here to log in. You may want to right click and click open it in a new tab here, but I would definitely highlight this information, right click and copy it, and then I would save it into a document and save it on your home page, because it's going to take a little bit of time. If you look at the page we just opened, it says a 404 page not found error, and it's because it takes some time to propagate with the servers with Hostgator. So you need to wait a little bit. It could even be a few hours before it works. But then when you get into the install page, which I'll show you here in a minute, I'll pause the video and then I'll reload it. I'll show you how to log in and then change this password to something that will be easier to remember. Okay, so I'm back. It took about 10 minutes for it to propagate for me, and it will likely take longer for you since it is the first time that you're doing this. And this is a subdomain for me, and I've already done this before. But what we can do once we get to this point is, if we still have this open, we can either right click and open this in new tab. And you're always going to have to log into what your domain name is here, /wp-admin, just as it says here. And you'll have to put in this username, and you're going to need to put in the password that it gave you for the first time here. So what we'll do is we'll go to the site here, and I'll put in my username, which is Tom Johnson, just as it is here, and it is case sensitive, so you need the capital letters, and I'll paste in my password here. Now I want to point out that if you lose your password, you can have it forwarded or sent to the address that we filled out within the area here in the quickinstall area just a moment before doing this step. And now we can log in here. Now, after we're logged into this is the WordPress dashboard that we're in now. The thing that you're going to want to do first is go up here in the right corner and then click Edit My Profile. This is the first thing that you should do every time, in my opinion. And then you go down. If you need to change your email address that you can retrieve the password at and be contacted at, this is where you would do that. And if you want to scroll down a little bit more, you can click on where it says Generate Password. I'm going to delete this, and I'm going to hide my password from you, put in a new password, and then it will say that the password is strong here for me. When I'm happy with that, I'll simply go down and I'll click Update Profile. Now, if you want to, you can log out by going up here and then clicking Log Out. Just hover over it and click Log Out, and you can log back in with your new password if you want to test out that it did work fine. And if there's a problem, you can retrieve it at the email that we have set up right in here as well. So I hope this was helpful. Feel free to check out other tutorials that I have where we actually go through step by step how to make a website while we're in this area. And feel free to subscribe to my channel. I hope this video was helpful in learning how to install WordPress on Hostgator. Thanks, everyone.